What's poppin', YouTube? Welcome to my channel, Astro Finesse. It's your boy Lil Finesse Jiggy Hippie, back with another video for y'all. And this video right here, we're gonna be talking about if you have Uranus in Cancer or Uranus in the fourth house. And I'll pause for the cause. If you don't know how to find your Uranus placement, if you're a new subscriber, if you're just starting off your journey of self-love, self-analysis, self-understanding, if you don't realize why it's so important that you have to learn about yourself, study yourself, and more importantly, love yourself through astrology or numerology, don't worry, I got you. There's a couple of videos. I'll put the link in the description. You have to watch them first to become hip to the knowledge of what I'm about to talk about right now. So if you look at your birth chart or your natal chart, it's the same thing, and you realize you have Uranus in the sign of Cancer or Uranus in the fourth house, which I have my Uranus in the fourth house, so I fuck with you on an even deeper level. I understand you on an even deeper level because I know a lot of us feel like we're misunderstood, and I'll get into that in this video. Just know that I understand y'all. I get y'all on a deeper level. This video is for you. So without further ado, let's just get it popping, shall we? Now, you already know before I start, I'm gonna give y'all a list of some celebrities so y'all could visually see what Uranus and Cancer people look like in reality. Then I'm gonna have a list of celebrities that have Uranus in the fourth house. So to start, we got Steve Jobs, Gandhi, Oprah Winfrey, Robin Williams, John Travolta, Denzel Washington, Jackie Chan, Jerry Seinfeld, Bruce Springsteen, and Stevie Wonder. Now, these are celebrities that have Uranus in the fourth house. So we got Angelina Jolie, Kanye West, Drake, Justin Timberlake, Jessica Alba, Tyra Banks, Zoe Saldana, Dr. Phil, Michael B. Jordan, and Ray Charles. All right, so boom, Uranus in Cancer or Uranus in the fourth house, what does that mean? First of all, what does Uranus mean and represent in astrology in your birth chart? So the planet Uranus rules Aquarius. So whenever you think of Uranus, think about Aquarius energy, which is eccentric, erratic, spontaneous. You really don't know what you're gonna see next. Out of the blue, things that happen unsuspectingly. Uranus kind of shakes things up. Uranus is the only planet in our solar system that goes on its side, so automatically always wants to rebel and shake things up, breaks traditions. So in your birth chart, Uranus, the planet, changes signs every 7 years. So you will have the same Uranus sign as those in your generation. What makes y'all different is the house that Uranus is in. So understand the sign that Uranus is in and look at the house, because that tells you what area in your life you want to shake things up, what area in your life you want to break traditions, what area in your life you want to rebel against the traditional norms. Uranus just likes to be spontaneous and erratic. Think of Uranus as a bolt of lightning. When it's thunderstorming, you look in the sky, you don't know when the next one is coming, but when it comes, it's unsuspecting, it's loud, you feel it, you just don't know when the next one is coming. So Uranus is like, you don't know what's going to happen, when it's going to happen, who's going to happen to. It's like you don't know what's going to happen or when, but when it happens, it's unsuspecting, it's uncurrent, it's like unsuspected changes and drastic changes. So having Uranus in Cancer or Uranus in the fourth house, and I'm going to be using myself as an example. I'm going to be using myself as a lot of examples in this video, because having Uranus in the fourth house, especially if you don't know astrology or if you don't really like research yourself and study yourself through astrology, you'll be going through life and not knowing why you feel the way you feel. You'll be going through life literally lost if you don't understand astrology, basically. So for me, having Uranus in the fourth house, I'll start off by saying Cancer energy, fourth house energy, is all about stability. It's all about family. It's all about security. Cancers love being secure. Cancers are the crab. They like being secure in their home, in their family life, and all that. So that's that fourth house energy. That Cancer energy is all about stability, security, family traditions. And Uranus comes in and shakes it up. It kind of makes it unsuspecting. It kind of makes it different. It breaks the traditions. It breaks all the comfort. It breaks all the family structure in a way. It makes it different. It makes you have to go through life, through your family life, through your fourth house energy, through your Cancer energy, different. So a lot of us have, in our childhood, goes through either our parents divorcing or either one or both of our parents being more distant because they're at work all the time, or there's more of a intellectual connection rather than like a nurturing connection. Uranus here does not like being confined in one space. So having Uranus in the fourth house or Uranus in Cancer, understand that your life, your childhood especially, you will feel like, damn, like, why is my family so different? Why do I feel so out of place here? Why don't I feel secure? Why don't I feel safe? Why don't I feel emotionally fulfilled here? Because Uranus just makes it, it kind of shakes it up, makes it different. So we go through a lot of times in our childhood where I use myself, like when I was a wee lad, when I was a young jit, back in the day, I'll say middle school to early high school before I even looked at astrology, I used to always ask myself, like, why is my family so different? Why am I so different from my peers when it comes to family life? Because I go to school and they'll be talking about how they went to vacation with their parents, how they did that with their parents, they all did all these things. And I'd be asking myself, because I was raised a Jehovah's Witness, a lot of y'all know this. I was raised a very strict African household, a lot of y'all know this. So I was always asking myself, like, why is my family so different? We, a lot of times, we feel like we are just so different when it comes to the family dynamic structure. So Uranus here makes us break traditions when it comes to our family structures. Like me talking about astrology right now, talking about spirituality in this way, it's kind of breaking the family tradition, because I was raised to like read the Bible, learn the Bible, don't look at astrology, it's the devil. So like we a lot of times go through periods of life where we just rebel against family traditions, rebel against family structure in a way. So keep in mind though, having this placement, when it comes to love though, when it comes to nurturing, because in our childhood we're used to not really feeling secure in our household, because we always want to break free, we always want freedom, we always want to have our own traditions set for us. So a lot of times in love, we will kind of like run away from nurturing energy, run away from love in a way. We will be weird when it comes to being nurturing to people in a very close, intimate way, because growing up, we didn't have that true nurturing energy that a lot of people had, because Uranus here made it different and shook it up. It made it more of an intellectual connection. So our parents probably were like more friends to us. Our parents probably told us the real things about life, gave us like real knowledge about life on an intellectual manner, but not really in a nurturing manner. So understand that as you're growing up, as you become an adult, you will realize that when it comes to nurturing energy and love and all the mushy gushy stuff, when it comes to emotions, we can really be weird about emotions. We can really be weird about really wanting to be submerged with one person for life and all that regular traditional family structure. We kind of have a different view of like a family structure kind of thing. We have a different view about love in a way. So understand that having this placement, and I'll use myself as an example, like I said, we have to work on not always pushing people away to the max because we love our freedom too much. A lot of times when it comes to love, when it comes to nurturing, when it comes to family life, we just love our freedom to the max. Uranus loves freedom, loves being by itself, loves being independent, spontaneous, erratic, eccentric. It just loves being its own person. So when it comes to family structure, when it comes to nurturing energy, when it comes to like emotions and all that, we just love our freedom to the max. So when we become parents in the future, we could be the type to actually like be like more of a friend to our children, or kind of give our children a lot of independence, a lot of freedom. We just love freedom to the max. So understand this, if you're dealing with a Uranus and fourth house person or Uranus and Cancer person, and they're being distant, they're being cold and all that, understand that that's kind of how they were wired growing up. Because growing up in your childhood, Uranus made it different. Uranus shook things up. Could have went through like either one or both of your parents being distant, divorces, changing houses all the time, moving a lot, not feeling stable within where you are. So it's like our inner stability has always been shooken up so much, we've always been craving freedom so much when it comes to our inner stability, that as we grow, become an adult, it's like freedom is what we feel secure in. Like having freedom to do what we want, having freedom to express ourselves the way we want, is how we feel secure. Because when we wanted to feel secure as a child, it's like we didn't really get that security that we needed in a way. And I'm not saying this so y'all could feel bad for me, feel bad for us, like, oh, poor baby and all that. The blessings we have with this is having Uranus in the fourth house is we can actually change our traditions. We can actually shake things up. We could progress our family traditions. We could just do things in a different way. progressively. Like for example, like when I become a parent, I'm going to actually teach my children about astrology and how to love themselves. I'm going to break the traditions of not looking at astrology and actually help them grow as like young children. So we can actually break traditions and progress it in a way. But understand, like, the downfall of this is that we can be looked at as very weird when it comes to nurturing energy, when it comes to loving, when it comes to that one-on-one energy. We can become very weird because we just love our freedom to the max. Like, we just love being able to be free. Uranus wants to be free. So whenever we feel like we're stuck in a situation, especially being stuck in a home that we have no freedom in, that's when we have the urge to like, nah, I want to change it. I want to switch up. I want to do something else. A lot of times in our household, in our room especially, like, we like to change our furniture around all the time. We just like things being different and changing constantly because we have always been like that as a child, growing up, realizing things changing abruptly, our family structure changing abruptly. You could have different type of people in your house come and go. It's like the family structure, your family life, your childhood will be very Uranian, will be very unconventional, will be very sporadic, very spontaneous, a lot of different things happening. So because of this, we grow up wanting our personal freedom, wanting our personal sense of fulfillment by being able to be free and being able to, like, you know, be nurturing to people. Because Uranus in fourth house really wants to, Uranus energy is Aquarius energy, it's all about humanitarianism. So we actually love on a deep level, we actually love nurturing people on a deep level. It's like we could do this, but then we know that I'm not about to nurture someone, I'm not about to help someone at the expense of my own freedom in a way. So it's like we are extremely nurturing people, but we know not to do it to the point that we feel like we're stuck or we feel like we are not being able to express ourselves or be free. So it's a balance of being able to help someone and love someone and then being able to allow that person to really confine you or feel trapped or feel not free to express yourself fully in that connection, in that environment, or in that relationship, if that makes sense. So Uranus in the fourth house people express ourselves through our breaking family traditions, through our nurturing energy, to the point that we're not being so submerged with something that we feel trapped, that we feel like we can't really move around. We just like to be free and be able to move around the way you want to move, but we crave stability, we love stability to the point that we always feel like we're out of place when we're going places. That's why I said in the beginning that a lot of us feel like we're just different or misunderstood, like the black sheep of the family, because we always feel like we're out of place, but we crave to feel in place. But we're so used to things shaking up so much, we're so used to things not being even peeled, we're so used to things being sporadic and spontaneous a lot. It's like whenever we're in a spot, we want that stability, we crave that stability, but then we expect things to shake up, we expect things to change. That's why us having freedom is what gives us like that sense of stability. It's like, I'm not gonna be too attached to something because I know it could change in any moment. So us having freedom gives us the leeway to actually be able to move around without being disappointed as we were as a child, because childhood, we wanted that stability, we wanted that emotional connection with our parents, with our family and all that. But then something happened that allowed us, that kind of made us look at that differently. So if you're dealing with a Uranus and Cancer person or Uranus and fourth house person, be patient with them. Understand that they love in a different way. They love deeply, but they love in a different Uranian, weird, eccentric way. That could be a lot for some people. They're like, well, I'm not about to deal with that. You can have that. You don't have to deal with us if you don't want to, but understand that we need that freedom to feel stable and secure within ourselves. So keep that in mind for this placement. If you have this placement, really try to understand yourself, look at your chart, really try to like heal yourself before you actually get into a relationship. Really fully understand yourself before you deal with other people, because you don't know how what you're doing, what your childhood was like can affect people around you. You can easily push people away that really want to be there for you. And I'm speaking this from experience. Like, understand that this placement, if you're not consciously aware of what's going on in your chart, if you're not consciously aware of like why you're doing what you're doing, why your childhood was the way it was, if you're not consciously aware of what's going on, then your person and you're just moving through life with no plan, with no like knowledge of yourself, you can hurt a lot of people. But if you're consciously aware, if you study yourself, if you love yourself, if you know who you are, you can then be able to put yourself in situations that benefit you and the other person, you can have like a thriving, good relationship. Like I said, I'm not saying that we're the type that we just want to be single for life and we just want to be free. We crave stability. We crave that nurturing energy. We just didn't have it growing up. So it's kind of like we express it in a different, weird, eccentric way. But all in all, though, the plus of this, like I said, is when we do something with our family traditions, when we break traditions, when we go against traditions or rebel against traditions, we kind of progress it and make it different and make it more futuristic. It's like traditions are old and they've been there for life. They've been there for years. And it's the same thing. What we do is we come in and we shake it up, we break it up, we change it, we progress it, and we help the family tradition, like, you know, progress and move forward for the next generations and all that. So keep in mind, having this place, it is tough if you don't know who you are, if you don't know why you do what you do. But put yourself in situations that give yourself freedom. You like to travel a lot, most likely like to change. Like, you just like, we just like change a lot because that gives us freedom of like, all right, so I'm not gonna be too stuck on this one thing. I'm gonna have freedom to do what I wanna do in the way. So that was my video on Uranus and Cancer, Uranus in the fourth house. Hope y'all enjoyed that. My next video is gonna be Uranus and Leo. You already know I'm about to go in. If you have subscribed to my channel, appreciate all y'all for real. But if you haven't subscribed yet, go ahead and hand out the go ahead and handle that one time for your boy. Don't forget to drink your water, mind your business, and be safe out here. It's your boy Lil Finesse Jiggy Hippie. I'ma see all y'all when I see y'all. Peace.